sort of downplayed the effect of tariffs, saying it's going to be isolated to certain sectors. Is that your view as well? When does it start falling here?
Agreed.
So it seems to be more describing here, if you're talking about a range-bound market, what's the best way to make money? Do you look, for example, I mean, there's been earlier in the year and kind of has subsided. We have a chart showing the Russell 2000 versus the S&P 500 as a ratio here. Certainly on the list. David and I have talked about that quite a bit this week. A pressing one. How big of a problem is that sort of selection that you're doing in the U.S. and those criteria that you're applying? Are you applying those same criteria to Europe?
Yeah, I think so.
Now, just avoid wholesale? Or are that? Because as we talked about earlier in the show, one of the things that some investors are watching is non-financial. That if there are some companies on sort of who are A, over-leveraged, and B, maybe on delicate footing, if you will, as we start to see rates go up more, that's going to present a problem. And we haven't seen, I mean, in terms of capital deployment, we haven't seen as much CapEx, right? Is that going to change, and how is that balance shift, if there is one, going to inform where the...
Fascinating story, very much on the news, because Harley-Davidson bikes, millennials, not so into Harleys. So
because now they have to sort of tread the line between being this iconic American brand and appealing to the American consumers, while also looking to growth yes. markets overseas, which want lighter, faster bikes.
Right.
And so evolving
right.
while not alienating that customer base.
And the good news for Harley is, right. I mean, David does, but like that's a whole different story.
No. GM tattoo, perhaps.
That's a Corvette.
It's a Corvette.
There we go. Let's move on to diamonds.
Yeah.
I mean, this seems like a no-brainer to me with the whole blood diamond issue. Why not get your diamonds in a lab if indeed they are of the same caliber? And it looks like increasingly they are.
They are, and interestingly...
You drive the price down.
They're not. It does.
It does.
They're cheaper.
It absolutely does. It absolutely does. And there are some big... forever. They are getting into this business and actually pricing out.
But do they eventually put themselves out of business?
Potentially. Yeah. That's a good business story.
And we'll come back and do that when it happens. Okay. Thanks to the thing that I find interesting is they're starting having a version of what we have in the United States in terms of
pop up in other places around the globe, Italy, as we've yep. been talking about, as well, global force.
And because of similar phenomena, such as basic wages not going
as well as the environmental concerns that we've been discussing
very big in
the other day as
That's
well,
right.
and right. their connection to Paris.
That's right. Okay, and coming up, James Bullard, St. Louis, for Daybreak on this Friday, August 24th. I'm David Weston, right here with Julie Hyman. Alex Steele is off today. Good to be with you, Julie.
Yeah, good to be with you for the last day of the week and for my tenure here filling in for Alex. She'll be back on Monday. Let's take a look at the week that we
come to pass.
That's a good point. And the stocks aren't exactly trading like we're going to see it this time.
True.
But they are perking up a little bit in European trading. So something to continue to watch there as we get to the end of earnings season here in the United States. And we're going to turn now to Bloomberg's Michael McKee. He is live in Jackson Hole. He's been there all morning long. He's going to bring us a lot of interviews, including right now James Bullard, who is president of the St. Louis Fed. S&P 500 continues, but not quite on the brink of a recession, Neela. It's good to see you. Economic growth to at least slow or tip into a recession. When is that perhaps going to start to meet stocks and put some pressure on stocks, which have potential risks out there?
There are,
of course.
Sure.
Well, I have a chart up of the small caps as ratios go up, for example, especially among millennials, people who are younger. We see household formation, cornerstone, right? But is that an outdated view, or is that still important? Daybreak, I'm Julie Hyman. Alex Steele is off to heard there from Jason Furman. It's so interesting, the idea of credit, isn't it, for economic growth?
But yes, yeah, so they think they education system, and they came up with their own. So they launched a series of these sector ETFs.
Brand new.
They're brand new.
Okay.
They just launched in
intelligence. Vani, back to you.